2021 CHR is an extra small crossover SUV that sits at the bottom of Toyota's lineup. It serves as an entry-level model akin to the Yaris or the Corolla. Like everything in this class, the CHR counts flashy styling as part of its appeal. Changes for 2021 are limited to the addition of more standard driver aids and a new trim level, though the CHR had an update in 2020 that brought with it new front-end styling and more features, including LED headlights and Android Auto smartphone compatibility. Overall, the CHR is a decent choice, but lags behind rivals such as the Hyundai Kona, Kia Soul, and Mazda CX-30. Toyota's smallest SUV receives a boost to its safety cred for 2021 with an updated suite of driver assistance features. Standard across the lineup is Toyota's Safety Sense 2.0 active safety system, which includes automated emergency braking with pedestrian detection, lane keeping assist with road edge detection, traffic sign recognition, automatic high beam headlamps, and adaptive cruise control with lane trace assist, which keeps it centered in the lane. On top of that, a new Nightshade Edition appearance package is available on the mid-range XLE model that blacks out much of the CHR's exterior trim and adds 18-inch black wheels. Typical Toyota quality abounds inside the CHR's cabin. The materials throughout the interior seem well chosen and durable. A faux leather dash with simulated stitching looks upscale, while diamond patterned plastic on the doors and similarly patterned headliner accents add a bit of fun to the mix. In low light situations, the trim used on the dashboard of XLE trim appeared to be standard issue piano black, but in direct sunlight, a metallic glaze shone through. Overall, the cabin has a very youthful appeal. When it comes to feature availability, though, the CHR is anything but up to date. Dual zone automatic climate control is the only basic luxury here, so those wishing for niceties, such as power seat adjustments or a sunroof, will be left wanting. For the engine, the CHR is powered by a 2.0-liter non-turbocharged i4, sending power through the front wheels with help from a CVT automatic. Thanks for watching, and give your comments below.